Friends, welcome back to Best Ready Study. In this video, we are going to see the preparation strategy, last minute tips, and most important topics for LIC ADO 2019 exam. So, coming to LIC ADO 2019 exam, it's going to be conducted tomorrow, that is on July 13, 2019. So, the students or the candidates who are going to attend to this particular exam, watch this video till this end because you are going to get so much important information and tips where you can score more marks in tomorrow's LIC ADO 2019 exam. So now let's begin our video. So coming to the most important topics and most important tips regarding this particular exam, first let's see about reasoning. Coming to reasoning, concentrate more on puzzles, blood relations, syllogism, data sufficiency and direction. Okay, so these five topics which I told you, most of the questions are going to be asked from this particular questions. So now let's see what are the topic wise tips which I can give you for reasoning. Coming to the puzzles, you have to concentrate more on puzzles because coming to puzzles, at least 2 to 3 questions will be asked from puzzles. So, and this is the topic where it consumes most of the time. So please concentrate and please keep practicing more and more puzzle questions. So coming to puzzles, they can ask any question regarding paper folding or any other puzzle questions or mirror images and all. So concentrate mostly on puzzles coming to reasoning. And coming to next topic in reasoning, the tips regarding seating arrangement questions are, coming to seating arrangement, first try to understand the question whether it is circular seating arrangement question or anti-circular seating arrangement question or linear or anti-linear. First try to assume that you are present in that question. Okay, assume that you are there as one of the person and keep thinking logically. Okay, because logical thinking really helps to solve this seating arrangement questions within very less time. Okay, and imagine the figure in your brain. So if they are asking you to solve the seating arrangement question by giving the question like all the people, like 6 people sat in the circular arrangement facing towards center or anti-center, against the center. So first try to understand the question well and then start solving the question. Okay, so coming to the direction sense test, it's very easy. Coming to the direction, you'll have the figure the 8 directions: north, south, east, west, northeast, northwest and all. You should have that figure in your brain always, because with the help of that diagram, within less than 30 seconds you can happily solve any direction test question. Okay, so have that figure in your mind always. Okay, so coming to the blood relation, yes, this is one of the most important tip I would like to give you. Coming to the blood relation, most of the students waste more and more time solving this particular questions. So I'm going to give you a simple tip where you can easily solve within 40 seconds. Like any blood relation questions, you can check out within 40 seconds of time and you can happily get the answer as well. So coming to the blood relation question, start reading the question from the last paragraph. For example, there's a paragraph which they gave you as blood relation question. So first read what is the question. Okay, how is A related to B? If this is the question, first read this question, the last sentence of the question, how is A related to B? Keep that in mind and start reading the question from last to first. Trust me, this is the helpful tip where you can solve any blood relation problem within less than 40 seconds. Okay, so once you start solving the blood relation problem from last to first, you can get answer within 40 seconds, which helps you in managing your time during exam. Okay, so follow this tip. Coming to the syllogism, you have to concentrate mostly on syllogism as well, because most of the questions will be asked from syllogism as well. So coming to the coding and decoding practice, okay, that's the only tip I would like to give you. Coming to coding and decoding, you have to, the more you practice it, more like the more it helps. Okay, so coming to the data sufficiency, Data sufficiency, it's not that hard. If you allocate just half an hour for data sufficiency questions practice for this last one particular day, it really helps. So now let's see about the numerical ability. Coming to the numerical ability, the important topics where you need to concentrate mostly are data interpretation, series data on sufficiency. Okay, I'm repeating: data interpretation, data sufficiency, series, and work and time, problem on ages, and also you have to concentrate on simplification problems. Okay, simplification problems are one of the problems where you can easily score marks. It's very easy. So now let's see the topic wise tips for the numerical ability. So coming to the data interpretation, concentrate 99%, you cannot ignore data interpretation, because you'll be having the questions like, you know, or tabular questions, bar graph questions, or you know, pie chart questions, any question they may ask you, and this is one of the topic where you can score maximum marks. Okay, so please concentrate mostly on the data interpretation and keep practicing more and more, and also practice on your time. Okay, the more you practice, the time reduces. Okay, remember this point. So coming to the numbered series, the series they may ask you, like, you know, they may give you a numbered series and they'll ask you to find out the wrong number in the series. This is one type of the question which they mostly ask you. And the second type of question is they'll give you a series. They'll give you 5 or 6 numbers in the series and they'll ask you what is the number which may come in the question mark place, like, you know, 5 numbers in a series and what number may appear in the 6th place. Okay, so these are the two kinds of problems which frequently appear coming to series. And coming to the simplification, you have to concentrate mostly on the simplification because it's must. The questions are going to come coming to the simplification. And coming to data sufficiency, it's always important, as I told you. And coming to the questions like LCM, HCF, profit and loss, you know, try solving these kind of simple questions within less than 20 to 25 seconds, okay? Because most of the students have knowledge about complete question, but they don't have time to solve. So time management is very important in this particular exam. So work on time management. And now let's see about English. Coming to the English, concentrate on reading comprehension, close test, spotting errors, and paragraphs. Okay, like, you know, the reading comprehension, paragraphs and all. So coming to the tips regarding the English language, coming to the reading comprehension, first read the question and then read the paragraph. Okay, so when you first read the question, you'll have the knowledge of the question and you'll start searching the answers regarding the question. So it really helps you and it really saves a lot of time. First, coming to reading comprehension, read the question and then the paragraph. Okay, and don't waste more than 1 minute for reading comprehension, for reading the entire paragraph. Okay, so within 1 minute 30 seconds at max, you should get answers of all the 5 questions. At max 2 minutes, so more than 2 minutes you're gonna allocate. You cannot allocate for reading comprehension because you'll be running out of the time if you allocate more time on reading comprehension. So manage your time. And English is the language, especially English, you will waste a lot of time. Like 95% of the students waste time in English because they know everything. They keep trying solving each and every question, so they run out of the time. So manage your time very well. And coming to the close test, it's very important. It's must asked question. It's going to be coming. It's going to appear in your tomorrow's exam. So please concentrate on close test as well. And sentence errors. Okay. So coming to the particular errors, one tip regarding this sentence errors is that they'll ask you, they'll give you the sentence and they'll ask you to find out the error. And 99% of the errors will be words like and, in, a, like you know the prepositions or the words like the small words like in, of, such kind of you know the words will be missing. So those will be the errors. Okay, so use logical thinking in solving the questions such as you know spotting the errors and all. Coming to the parajumbles, it's important, and also concentrate on improvising your grammar, okay, because it really helps you to score more marks coming to English language. So now let's see the tips regarding solving the sections, okay. So coming to the reasoning ability, you'll be asked 35 MCQs and 35 MCQs 20 marks, so you can understand the situation, right? So coming to reasoning, for 35 questions you just have 20 minutes, so within less than 30 seconds you have to solve reasoning, and at max to one or two questions you can allocate till 1 minute, at max to one to two questions, not more than one to two questions. So for all remaining questions you have to solve within 40 seconds at max, okay, max. And coming to the aptitude, 35 questions 20 minutes, same. So you should keep on you know using the formula, using the tricks and techniques in solving the aptitude questions within less time. And coming to English, you'll be having 30 questions 20 minutes. You feel that it is one of the most easiest section, but it is one of the most time consuming section. So now let's see what are the last minute tips regarding LIC ADO 2019 exam. So coming to this particular exam, keep giving mock tests. There are many mock tests available online. So keep giving mock tests, because each and every mock test will help you in analyzing your performance and analyzing your time consumption. It really helps, trust me. So keep giving mock tests and keep revising the topics which you are taking more and more time in solving regarding any particular section. It might be reasoning or aptitude or English. And third tip which I would like to give you is keep referring to the previous papers, so that you'll have an idea like which particular section, like you know which particular question in particular section is frequently repeating, and what questions you don't know, and where you need to concentrate more. All this analysis you can do only when you have the knowledge about the previous year's questions, okay. And the fourth tip which I'm telling you since the first minute of this video is manage your time and don't run out of your time. And the fifth important tip is that please be confident and please be present at your exam center at least before 1 hour. It's must, because most of the students they rush at the last moment, they'll be panicked, disturbed, so the questions which you know also you will forget at that moment. So and the last important tip which I would like to give you is please don't start preparing new topics at the last moment, okay. You already prepared few topics which are very important, so keep revising this last day, okay. So please don't go to the new topics, or once you see the new topics you don't know that, you'll be tensed, and in that tension you may even forget the questions which you are confident and which you know, okay. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more such videos and hit the bell icon for more such videos and notifications. Like and share this video with all your friends. And tomorrow I'm going to do LIC ADO 2019 exam paper analysis. So to be notified, to get that video notification, you know what to do. Subscribe, share, like and hit the bell icon. All the very best for your exam. Thanks for watching and be confident.